So most of the software engineering interview questions fall into this category. Yeah. So these are the techniques that you should use to optimize time and space complexity while... Hey guys, Sandeep here. Welcome to Interview Dose. Today I'm going to solve few problems from arrays. Why arrays? Because most of the interview questions fall into this category. We will discuss some of the common techniques to help you solve these problems. Usually the first round, which is the coding round, revolves around arrays problems. Okay, 90% of the time, almost always the array problem. Let's start with the first problem. You can see an array with few elements. The goal here is to find the index of n once it is sorted. There are many ways that we can solve this. One way is to sort this and return the index of 10, which will be 2. Now let's think about a simpler solution without sorting it. What we can do, we can take two buckets, B1 and B2. 10 is our pivot element, right? We will scan through the array, and if the number is less than the given number, which is 10, then we will put it into B1 bucket. And if the number is greater than the given number, then we will throw it to B2 bucket. Okay, so let's do that. 12 is greater than 10, so we'll put it in B2 bucket. 9 is less than 10, so we'll put it into B1 bucket. 7 is less than 10, so we'll put it into B1 bucket again. And 15 is greater than 10, so we'll put it into B2 bucket. Finally, we are done. And we can clearly see that B1 bucket has two elements, so 10 is having the third position, right? This is one way where we had to use two extra buckets of total size O of n again. But the time complexity is O of n, right? Because we just scanned through the array once. In this problem, we have used extra space. Let's try to do this in place. In the in-place algorithm, we'll use two pointers. One is for scanning all the elements, and another is for marking the elements. Okay, let's say the two pointers are I and J, and let's initialize them with start of the array, which is 0. So I equal to 0 and J equal to 0. Let's say J is our scanner and I is our mark. Okay, now what will we do here? We will scan through the elements in the array, and if the element is smaller than the pivot element, then we will swap with our marker. Let's scan it. 12 is not less than 10. We'll move the J to the next index. 9 is less than 10. So we found a candidate. Let's now swap this 9 with 12. So array of J and array of I will be swapped. So let's write 12. Let's write 9 here. Move J to the next index. Move I to the next index. Okay. Now let's look at 7. 7 is less than or equal to 10 again. So we found another candidate. Let's swap it with I again. 12 and this is 7. Move I to the next index and J to the next index. Okay, good. Now 15 is not less than or equal to 10. We'll still move J to the next index. Now, once the scanning is over, we found the final index of 10, right? So, we will swap this 10 to this place. So, finally, this will be 10 and this will be 12. And we will return I equal to 2. Okay? So, what we did here in a for loop, for J equal to start, J less than array length, J. If array of J is less than or equal to pivot, then we swap array of J and array of I plus plus. In the for loop, J is already incremented, so we don't have to increment that anymore. After this for loop is over, we swap the array of I with the pivot. Okay, finally return I. Yeah, this is good. Now let's solve another problem. Yeah, let's talk about a very simple problem, reversing a string. String is nothing but array of characters. So what we can do, we can take two pointers. One points to the beginning of the array and another points to the end of the array. We can start a loop. And using these two pointers, we can swap the values and we are done. Right? This is good. Now let's talk about another problem. Valid palindrome. Yeah. Given a string, determine if it is a palindrome or not. We will take the same exact approach, but we will just, instead of swapping here, we'll compare them, right? And if we find any non-matching character, then we can say that it's not a palindrome. If all the characters are matching, then it is a palindrome, right? Now, let's modify this problem a little bit, okay? So let me show you a problem from LeetCode, valid palindrome. This is the same problem we are dealing here, but with a little twist, right? So, yeah. So right here in this problem, what it says is we have to consider only alphanumeric characters and ignore cases. Okay. So we have to consider only alphanumeric characters and we have to ignore cases. Okay. We have two constraints. So we just have to add another two step in the for loop or while loop. First step, we'll be checking whether the character is a letter or a digit. Then we just have to ignore them, right? So if it is not alphanumeric character, which is nothing but it is a digit or a letter, then we have to skip them. So that's the first step that we will do, right? In the second step, we have to transform this character into one case. It can be uppercase or it can be a lowercase character. So normalize them first, right? And then compare them. And if they are not matching, we can immediately say that it's not a palindrome, right? Without looking at the solution, I encourage you to pause this video and do it first. The reason why I am asking you to do this, you will get to know where are you making mistakes. This is very simple but very important problem to deal with. So pause this video and do it yourself first. Solve this problem yourself first. Awesome if you have done it in one shot. Okay. If not, I want you to pay attention to the places that you made mistake. Okay. This particular problem is going to help you a lot in the interview. Okay. This problem is going to help you a lot solving problems dealing with multiple pointers. Okay. By solving this problem, you will get to know which loop you are very comfortable with. It can be solved using a for loop. It can be solved using a while loop. But is this while loop is better than using a for loop or for loop is better than using a while loop? You will get to know. You might feel comfortable using a for loop. I feel comfortable using a while loop for this problem. This is what I always do. If I feel comfortable using while loops for this kind of problems, then I always use while loop. Be mindful of using what loop you are going to use for a problem like this. Okay, this is the main takeaway from this problem. I encourage you to remember few methods which are available in character and string class, which are going to be very, very helpful in interviews. For example, in this problem, you have to use each letter or digit method from character class. Also, you might have to use two lower or two uppercase method from character class. Okay, let me show you this solution. This is what I did. Okay. Yeah, I have taken two pointers, I equal to 0, j equal to length minus 1 and started a while loop. In the while loop, I am checking if the character at I is not a letter or a digit, then increment I. Similarly, for j, check if it is not letter or a digit, then decrement j and continue. In the next step, convert the characters to the lowercase. Convert the character at I and J to lowercase and compare, and if they are not matching, then return false immediately. We continue doing this process until I is less than J. And finally, if we have not returned false in this while loop, okay, this is a palindrome and we will return true. So that's the solution. So in this session, my goal was to tell you these two techniques. One with two pointers from two opposite directions. In another technique, we have used the same two pointers, but from one side of the array, both moving in different speed, right? These are the techniques that you should use to optimize time and space complexity while dealing with arrays or string, you know, all these linear data structures. Thanks, guys. See you next time. Thanks, guys.